When reading or writing the tape, it gets pulled along the read-write head behind this cover. This is happening when this roller presses the tape against this constantly rotating capstan. I've prepared a very simple program, and now when we are going to hit start, you can see the roller do a little move to pull the tape, and you could see the tape loops in the vacuum columns move a little bit. It's important to mention that the reels haven't moved up to now. The reel movement is totally independent from the tape reading or writing. The reels only manage to keep the length of the tape loops in a certain range between two sensors. Observe the tape loop and the reels as the loop gets closer to the sensor when we continue to read the tape. The reel starts when the tape has gone beyond the sensor, and it stops as soon as the loop is back again in the middle range. So the tape transport, the left reel and the right reel are totally independent, and so may move totally asynchronously. That's the cause why the movement appears so fascinating, much more impressive than on a regular audio tape.